Hey guys, Bettina Ray here. Welcome back to my channel where I share all things to do with motherhood and yoga and just enjoying life with a young family. So today I want to talk to you about five things you can do to make the school year a little less painful. If you read my blog post, and I'll link it below, that I wrote at the end of last year, you'll know that I didn't really embrace school as I probably should have at the start of last year. I was really kind of like, I don't know, in denial about the whole thing and that it was happening, and I did not get myself organized in any way. And that was a huge mistake because it just made it so much more stressful. So not making the same mistakes twice. This year, grade one, I feel like I'm getting this school mum thing. I'm gonna be good at it by the end of this year at least. Let's get into the video. Five things to think about to make the start of the school year a little less painful. So my first tip has to be lunchboxes. Buy yourself some good lunchboxes with the little sections so you only need the one lunchbox. Two max if you want to add a sandwich separate to the kind of snack box. And the reason for this is because you really don't want to be rifling through your Tupperware drawer every morning for 40 weeks of the year. It sucks. Buy yourself the good lunchbox. Yes, they're expensive, but they're so worth it. We got ours last year, we got the Yum Box. I'll link below this for that as well. And it's still going. So I got two last year for both of my boys and they're both in perfect condition. I can't complain about them in any way. And it has just taken that headache out of my mornings completely. The second tip is make yourself a command center. I hate this term, command center. Basically, it's just a space in your home where everything is organized to do with school. Food for us as well, because for me it's all wrapped up together having to organize food and be on top of that and not just la-di-da, what am I going to make today? Where you can also organize all the school notes, because oh my god, school sends home so many notes. And it's really hard to keep on top of them, even if you do them straight away and stick them back in the bag. I don't know, we still seem to lose so many things. So somewhere you can keep all the notes together. I also use our center to organize things like bills and what we're doing in the week, so what our work looks like, just so we're kind of all on top of it. Ours also keeps our bags, so I know where the school bags are. The boys know they have to put them in that spot. Lunch boxes, library bags, swimming bags, everything. It's all in the one spot, and we've got calendars so we can kind of see what's up and coming. So if you haven't already, try and make yourself a little corner of your home where you've got everything together. It's a lifesaver. My third tip is to get into some really good routines for you. So I resisted this like crazy, and I don't know why, because I've worked in the schooling system, I've been a teacher for 10 years, and yet I could create routines in the classroom, but I resisted making them at home. But things for me, like routines around shopping for food, making and preparing food, and washing have been huge. So I have days that I have to wash because we've only got three uniforms, so I have to wash on a Wednesday, obviously have to wash on a Sunday, which we usually do anyway, and shopping. So I made it that, okay, I'm going to do a big shop on a Sunday, so we're starting the week right, and on a Wednesday, I'm going to do a top-up shop. And it's just having that routine that I do it every week. I don't know, it just avoids the last-minute run to IGA or your local shop for all the things that you need before school. So seriously, get some routines around that. Again, put it up on a calendar so you know when to do it and you stick to it. And it doesn't have to be just you doing it as well. It could be your partner. They could do the top-up shop, you could do the big shop. Share it around, I'm all for delegating. So number four for me is routines for your kids as well. It's gonna help you out so much if they know what they have to do and you're not like at the last minute going, come on, shoes on, where's your shoes, where's your socks, get everything ready. So for us, it's really basic. We've got routines around the school and getting ready. So before he can do anything he wants to do of a morning, he has to have had breakfast, which is fine because my children want to eat the minute they wake up. He has to be dressed with socks on as well, because for some reason socks are always really hard to find. So he has to get socks on. So he's pretty much ready for the day before he can do anything else. So that really helps, because then it means in the last 10 minutes, I'm not having to say, do all this, it's already done and he's ready to go. We've also got little routines for the end of the day as well. So he knows, again, before he can play, he has to unpack his lunchbox, put his freezer pack in the freezer so it's ready to go for the next day, so that we always get the lunchbox out of the bag, because we found last year it would get left in the bag and then the next day you're like, oh my God, the lunchbox is still dirty, there's no freezer pack. So having him do it has been amazing. And sort of related but kind of not related to school, I've also got him unpacking the dishwasher twice a week. So this is the first year we've kind of introduced the whole idea of chores for pocket money, and so far it's really helping. So two mornings a week he unpacks the dishwasher as well, which is really helpful. So that might be a whole nother video. It's not really related to school, although I guess it does help us all get out the door in the morning. And the final tip I have is about meal planning. And again, something I resisted for so long, I still really dislike doing it. In fact, what I'm working on at the moment is like 4 meal plans. I'm just gonna recycle those babies every month throughout the year. So that's kind of my plan at the moment. I'm working on creating some meal plans that we really love, and I'm just gonna use them every month. But honestly, as much as I hate it, meal planning is so helpful. It's kept our money down, which was a big goal for me this year, and not spending so much money on food. And also it means that when I stick to that routine of shopping on a Sunday and on a Thursday, we always have food for lunchboxes, which for whatever reason, lunchboxes do my head in. Is it just me, or are lunchboxes one of the most painful things? Hit me up in the comments if you agree that lunchboxes kind of suck. Anyway, so that's it. They're my 5 tips for making the start of the school year a little less painful. If you've got any other tips for me, I would love to hear them. Please help me out. I'm still really only learning this whole school mum thing. And of course, it's gonna change completely in another 5 months or so when this bub arrives, and I'm gonna do it all with a newborn. So let me know if you like this video. Make sure you subscribe if you haven't already. Have a great week, and I'll see you next week.